definitely, thank goodness you're here.
She's requested time.
We do not have time. Stand back.
No offence, sister, but I believe you were the last person she would like to see.
And what is that supposed to? Are we sure she's even in there?
Of course she isn't.
Where else would she be?
Climb through a window, escape through the chimney.
Quiet. She may hear you.
Do you realise I left my husband and child at home for this?
I told everyone this would happen. Now we're to be late for the Queen.
Shh. I hear something.
Anthony.
If one of you utters a single word, this gets over with.
I despise you.
Lady Bridgerton, Miss Bridgerton. Such a shame your presentation at court was so rudely interrupted.
Shame indeed.
I nearly forgot you were making your debut this season. After your elder sister's triumph. Perhaps good fortune might run in the family.
It is a delightful ball, Your Majesty. Very diamondy. Though I must admit, I'm more of an emerald person myself.
My favourite necklace is one of emeralds. How thoughtful of you to know that. It seems you have indeed come a long way since last year, Miss Bridgerton.
Can I ask you something, Miss Eloise? Did I purposely make the third wicket 2 inches narrower than last year? Yes, I did. Anything?
I fear I may have upset the Viscount during our game.
You were near our father's grave. Well, then his mood was not on your account. He rarely goes near the site if he can help it. Can I ask you something? Was it your choice you never married? My brothers tell me I have a habit of being rather direct. But everyone tells me it is fate worse than death to end up a spinster. But you seem perfectly content with your situation.
You must know it is hardly ideal. The world is not exactly welcoming to an unmarried woman. There seems to be no place in society for us except at the edge of things.
That rather seems to be society's flaw, not a woman's.
Indeed it does.
My rebellion is not some party dress I put on to play a part, Mama, and it is certainly not some accomplishment I have developed, like singing or painting to help me attract a suitor. No. I am a disappointment to you, so just allow me to take my leave and go to bed.
So you're an admirer of my work?
I would not go so far. It is serviceable, I suppose.
And yet you have come far. You're a long way from Mayfair for writings that are merely serviceable.
Luckily for me, there is a thrilling invention called a carriage that may convey a lady from one place to another. It is a marvel, to be sure.
What's your name?
Eloise Bridgerton.
Pleased to meet you, Miss Eloise. I'm Theo Sharp.
I know.
You know.
As I know, there are several errors in your arguments that I must bring to your attention. Have you a pencil? Never mind. You may borrow mine. When I read something new or interesting or provoking, it is you who crosses my mind. It is you I would like to speak with about those thoughts.
I see.
And so I am wondering, you might also have thoughts of me when you think. But she is quite crafty. If Madame Delacroix is involved, she will never admit it. Yet another clue that will only lead nowhere. Oh, not bothering at all.
Forgive me. I would never.
No, this whole thing, it is absurd. We cannot continue to meet like this.
This was your idea.
You know, I know it was. And I'm sorry for wasting your time.
Are you? Or are you suddenly dropping out of this hunt for other reasons?
People are already talking about us, Theo. And no, I do not normally care what other people think, but yes, I care about you. And if we continue on like this, I could not live with myself if you are the one who has to face the consequences.
I should have known. But you could not be any different from all other ladies. It's all right, Miss Bridgerton. You dipped your toe into my waters, trying to make yourself feel better about the unearned advantages of your birth. Now you can go back to your life. And I can go back to mine. I'm sorry I couldn't help you find your writer. Best of luck.
Theo.